So my basic setup for studio portraiture for athletics, I have two Explore 600s and two 60-inch soft boxes. One, I have a fill light there that's meant to fill in the shadows, and the main light is what's providing the majority of the light. For me, I usually use the 60-inch soft box at 1/4 power, put it as close to the athlete as possible. And the other light is a fill light. It's just filling in the shadows that you'll find on the left side, but it's lightly filling them in because you want a three-dimensional look. So this is somewhat of the setup that I'll have those two lights in. I usually have them up and angled down some because that's a better lighting than having it just blasting face forward. The light on the right, the fill light, I have that feathered so that the light is coming past them a little bit. I don't have it pointing directly at them. I'm just getting the edge of the softbox light. So this is what the basic shot will look like if you just use the one main light. And this looks good. You'll notice the shadow on the side, the left side of the body is a little darker. It gives three dimensionality. This is with the key light and the fill light. So it's more filled in, which tends towards a flatter look, but I'm still able to get some three dimensionality because I keep that other light at half of the power of the first light. These are my kicker lights. They're in 20 or 40 degree honeycomb grids. The grids just keep the light from spilling into the camera. And these are just meant to highlight the sides of the face, the arms, lights that go down the side of the body. It's kind of meant to simulate stadium lighting, actually. This is where it comes from. So this is what a shot with just the kicker lights only. And that's what the kicker lights kind of do in the highlighting. And then here's a shot with the fill light and the main light, as well as the kicker light. So the four light setup is basically giving me a even but not flat lighting that I achieve with using the vary ratio. So there's still some shadow to give it a three-dimensional look, but not too much shadow and not too dramatic, because I have to be conscious of the fact that the graphics people will be pulling these out and compositing them into graphics that may not lean towards the need for the heavy shadow or even the dramatic look. When I do want to go for something that's more dramatic though, I'll go to a three light setup. I'll remove the fill light. I use the two kickers in the back, and I'll have the subject stand right behind the soft box, and I'll feather the light across them. So the light is basically shooting across the person. So this lighting style tends to be a little more moody. The images are more dramatic. The background will go darker because the light is not hitting the background anymore. It's coming across the subject. And this is my favorite style of lighting. A lot of times I like to do a one light setup where just the main light and the subject is behind the soft box, and I'll have it feathered shooting across them. And I use that a lot. A lot of times it's not about the how many lights you have, but knowing how to create the mood and feel with the one that you do have. So the multiple light setup has its practical purpose, but you can do good photography with just one light, one main light.